Hi everyone, I'm Jen Call, and I'm a member of the Board of Directors for the Boys and Girls Clubs of Greater St. Louis. And I'm pleased to share with you my personal career path experience. Today I'm going to share information about my organization, my role, and how I ended up in this career path. I currently work for U.S. Bancorp Community Development Corporation, the Tax Credit and Community Development Division of U.S. Bank. There I am the Director of Affordable Housing Asset Management. My organization does community development work, which myself and my colleagues find both rewarding and fulfilling. Our specific role as an organization is really not that well known unless you're a part of the industry, and so where I will start today is by telling you about what we do at U.S. Bancorp Community Development Corporation, also known as USBCDC, or the CDC, affectionately by those of us that work there. The government has several programs that support investments in affordable housing, historic buildings, economic development, and renewable sources of energy. Those government programs make available the tax credits and other benefits to private organizations like U.S. Bank with the goal of investing and creating positive impact in underserved communities. So it's basically a way of getting private corporations and the government to partner together to bring money into the communities that need it most. My role in the organization is within the Affordable Housing Group. My team invests in projects that support the development of multifamily housing that is specifically reserved for individuals with low incomes. To ensure we and our communities continue to receive the tax credit benefit, my team monitors these properties through the compliance period under which they operate, which is for 15 years. My team is referred to as the asset management team. We monitor the construction of the properties, we watch as they lease up, and we ensure that these properties continue to operate as housing for people across the country. When I first started in this job, I managed my own portfolio of properties, and over time, I've taken on more and more responsibility, and now I manage a team of about 60 professionals that, through their different roles, manage our portfolio of investments and loans. Both our properties and our team are located all over the country, and one of the things that I like the most about my team is how diverse both the people and the work is. The work we do every day involves things like visiting construction sites, writing memos, giving presentations, managing client relationships, analyzing financial statements, and a variety of other items that make it so that no day is exactly the same. Because that work I mentioned is so wide-ranging, we have a team of people that possess different kinds of skills and backgrounds. And while everybody has a four-year degree and some type of prior work experience, you could be successful in this role with a number of different backgrounds. Some examples are legal, accounting, construction, economics. We even have a few people who majored in social work. So to talk a little bit about myself, I did go to a four-year college, but I wasn't sure what exactly I wanted to do. Initially, I had an interest in journalism because I loved to write. So what I decided to do was major in English with an emphasis in writing. Additionally, I had two minors, one in communication, which I thought could support me if I did choose to go into journalism, and one in education, which I thought I could use to become a teacher. I even had a radio show in college, and I read the news on the campus radio station frequently. But as you know, I am neither a journalist nor am I a teacher. What actually led me down my current career path is an extracurricular organization I joined while attending college. I've always been interested in and acted as a leader, whether that was running for student council in high school or even just as someone who was typically the social organizer and planner for my group of friends. And because of that, I volunteered in a position as treasurer for my sorority. That position and the background it gave me in simple accounting led me to an internship at a title company, which was my first exposure to real estate. I ended up interning at that company whenever I was off school for about a year and a half, and I was ultimately offered a full-time job when I graduated. And while it may seem like that's a completely different direction than what I was studying for, I think it's important to recognize that it was through my educational institution that I received the foundational experience and access to internship opportunities that led me to that position at the title company. I will also say that the ability to write and the comfort I have in speaking in front of large groups is a skill that I have learned through my formal education, and that has helped me in every job I have ever had and in so many ways in my personal life. Now, without getting into the exact details of the other positions I've held, it was at that title company where I met and impressed one of my clients who was a real estate developer. And as a result, when I felt like I was ready to do something new, that client agreed to hire me to work in property management. And my boss there in that position told me that while I was working at the title company, there was an exact interaction he had with me where I was able to make a decision quickly and demonstrated professionalism and flexibility that made him decide to hire me. And what I think is interesting about that is you just never know what in your career can be determined by a single interaction, or even in your personal life for that matter. Similarly, when I worked in property management, I managed properties in downtown St. Louis that included a combination of residential lofts, retail, and office space. And my office was in the lobby of the same building where I currently work today. Every day, employees of the CDC walked past my office and I interacted with them regularly, helping them solve issues in the building. And when they hired me in 2010, I was already a familiar face and they had already had a lot of positive experiences with me. I started at the CDC as an assistant asset manager, and while I already had some background in real estate and had recently received a graduate degree in business that I obtained in the evenings while working full-time, I did not have experience in the specific government programs I mentioned before. However, it didn't really matter because I was really hired to be in a support role supporting the asset management team. And that was 10 years ago. So what I will say is that Thomas Jefferson said, "I'm a great believer in luck, and I find the harder I work, the more of it I have." And that is most certainly what I did. I learned everything I could. And when I had extra time, I asked for more work. And in a little over a year, I was promoted to asset manager and I had my own portfolio. By the time I've been at the CDC for 4 years, I became a manager. And it turned out that my ability to communicate with people made me an excellent leader and an excellent advocate for my team. And when the director of our team left in 2017, I interviewed for and was offered that position and found myself managing a team of 30 people. And since that time, through organizational changes and shifts, my team has doubled in size and includes people working in a number of different roles supporting our business. So here I am, leading a team of about 60 people in something I did not receive a formal education in and for which 10 years ago I had minimal experience. And while I manage a large volume of business, I consider that my primary responsibility is managing my team. And I could not have gotten to that position without understanding our business and getting a formal education, but the skills and qualities that have taken me to the next level are about being able to connect with people and having strong leadership intuition. And that is something I always knew I had. So that's about me. When I was in middle school or high school, I did not know the career that I have today, where I literally get to help build communities, even existed. But I am fulfilled every day by the work and the people that I do that work with. There are a lot of careers out there, just like mine, where you don't know much about them, and there may not be a really standard path to get there, and sometimes you're preparing for something that is uncertain, like I was, and that's okay. But here's some tips I would share based on my experience. First, I would say focus on your time management. Think about how you're spending your time and what you're getting out of that. In my career, I've always found that being able to manage my time well gave me the space I needed to push myself to get to the next level. And also, it has allowed me to maintain a healthy work-life balance, which I find to be really important. Second, what I would say is take advantage of the experiences that are offered to you. Maybe you decide to run for student council or go on a school-sponsored trip or attend career day. You never know what career you might stumble upon or who you might meet that could help you in the future. And finally, I would say lean into your strengths. Not everything is about the degree you have or your educational background or your work experience. Those things are important, and many times they're what get you an interview and they could even be what get you hired, but what helps you advance in your career is often being able to use your strengths in the right way. If you're good at talking to people or you're creative or you like teaching people, those are things that can be a part of any career, and if you find ways to use them in your current job, that will help you move to the next level. Thank you for letting me share with you today. If you have any questions, please send those to gotquestions@bgcstl.org. Thank you. Stay safe and be well.